Hello, I'm Nige.
I'm Anders. Welcome to the Beer Kit Review. We're doing one of mine today. Yeah. It's the Festival Razorback. Yeah. Festival. Do a range of beers. I have to say, if you're a beginner, what a great place to start. They really are very easy. But we're doing the Razorback, which will come with a pattern of 3 kilograms of malt. You've got 650 grams of brewing sugar. You get a pack of Centennial and Summit hops. And then you've got some primary sugar to add at the end there. And it comes in, it should come in at about 5.7%. Mine came in slightly lower than that.
What sort of, is it our American IPA or pale ale?
It's a pale ale.
American pale ale with the American,
and like I say, it should come in at about 5.7%. I'm slightly below that, 5.5.
But once you add the priming sugar in, that takes it up another 0.2.
We'll come to that a bit later on.
Okay, so
get your beer can on, Nigel.
I will, I'll just fire that up. That's all. Let's get it into the glass.
Do it. I brewed this, and when I bottled it, it was weeding at about 4.5% ABV, which seemed too big a gap. But I left it a couple of weeks and took the first bottle out, gave it a little go, tested it. And like I said, came in at 5.5.
Yeah, mine's a little bit actually. I didn't put this in the fridge.
You didn't?
No, but well, it's quite cold where it was, so it's. But it looks stunning. So you're still not washing the labels off your bottles. That does annoy me. That.
Well, that's fine. I don't care. But that's nice and clear.
The light there, can you see the
that's lovely. That looks a bit like Will-O-The-Wisp.
That's like an ice cream head on it.
It is, isn't it?
God, the bubbles in there, the lots of really small fine bubbles.
Yeah,
that's a really good sign.
And nice and clear.
Oh. What a glorious aroma.
There's a slight citrus hint to that, isn't there?
What, slight? It's quite strong.
Yeah, you tell me what you get. Go on.
Right, I'm going in.
Go on.
Well, the first mouthfeel, it's lovely. The first thing that really hits me was the bitterness.
Mm-hmm.
You get the sweetness of the malts, but the bitterness was there right up front, and then it melts away to some fruitiness. Not citrus. Citrus hints there, but it's
berries.
Yes.
I think right at the end, I'm getting a hint of
dark fruits almost.
Yeah.
Forest fruits, as I like to say.
there's a lot going on. One thing I will say about this, and I took a leaf out of your book. I think this was the first homebrew that I've done where I used bottled water.
Rather than just out of the tap.
Yeah. And you can tell the difference straight away. The taste is a lot cleaner.
Yeah.
That could be down to many other factors. I don't know. But
yeah.
It just does feel like it's
deep in the water. If you use tap water, you got chlorine, there's fluoride in it, there's all sorts of gunk in it. They make it so apparently to make it safe to drink. But if you want to get rid of the chlorine in the water, if you pour it into your pot that you're going to, and just leave it off overnight, and I think the chlorine just evaporates off.
All right. Okay.
Or I think you can put Camden. You put something in it to, and it negates the
Camden tablets. Would they do that?
There's something anyway. But I live in Malvern, so we've got water gushing out the hills the whole time. So I lots of people collect the spring water directly from the spring here. So I've got an endless free supply.
Well, yeah. In fairness, I can go down to a local supermarket. And oddly enough, if you buy a little bottle of water, it's £1.50, £2. Buy a big couple of
5 litre ones,
and they're just cheap as chips. So you know you can get your water sorted out for under £10.
Yeah. Have a look on YouTube. There's loads of videos on water profiles and what have you. If you want to get that deeply into it, go for it. If your beer tastes good, don't try and break what ain't fixed.
Fair point.
But I am enjoying this.
It's it's got a slight creamy taste to it. It tastes slightly creamy to it at the start.
So, I have had one of these the other day. And I had it out of the fridge because you gave me a few bottles.
Mm-hmm.
And it was out of the fridge, cold. It was awesome. This is, although it's not ice cold, it's got a slightly different profile. I've getting more fruitiness from this, which I didn't get when it was out of the fridge. Out of the fridge, it was still nice. It was quite refreshing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure which one I prefer.
Do you know what? I'm with you because I've had a couple, all straight from the fridge.
Yeah.
This one was in the fridge. I took it out about an hour ago.
Yeah.
It's acclimatized. And like you say, there's more going on. I don't know. The one straight out of the fridge is far more refreshing. A bit more flavor.
Yeah.
It 6 2/3, really. Well, we had a little break there, didn't we?
Which was totally pointless because we had a little break where I thought, oh, we're almost finished and we came straight back in. It's going down so quick, this is lovely.
It is. The other thing is that also, because it's homebrew, you're not pouring the whole bottle out. Otherwise, you're going to get a whole load of...
Yes. So it wasn't, and they're 500ml bottles, so they're not even a pint, so you're not even... Yeah. In our defence, you're on a...
Yeah, indeed. But I'm very happy. All of the festival beers I've brewed have been excellent. We did I think it was the Summer Glory.
Gorgeous.
That was lovely too.
Oh, in fact, I might look out for that. I think I might brew that next springtime.
Yeah, that was a corker. And then last year, probably around this time last year, I did the Pride of London Festival Porter,
which was just adorable. I love it. It was that vanilla. It was, it was fantastic.
That
didn't last very long, though, did it?
No, it didn't. No.
So no, actually, I've done one festival kit in the past. You've done quite a few. I don't. There's been a bad one, is there?
I don't think there has. I think you can safely say they're a pretty safe brand to start with.
And you've had and they've all worked.
Good
hit rate.
It is. So two Razorbacks, the Summer Glory, the Festival, London Porter, all excellent. All nice. Very satisfactory. Yeah.
So that one was Festival's Razorback, American Pale Ale. Buy it, try it, drink it.
Yeah.
I don't think you'll be disappointed.
I don't think you will, no. So, from us, thanks for watching. You know, like, comment, subscribe, and all of that. Until next time, au revoir.
Bye then.